You know what? Just recently we started singing this little song. That's the most different little song we ever sung in our concerts, and we've done it because of kids. Most of you have been kids, or you know some, and you know. And I think there are some people who have never been kids. They just kind of enjoy being miserable. They look in the obituary column, get up every morning, look in the obituary column, if their name isn't there, well, they put their clothes on and go about their... But we love kids. We've got three little ones at home. We just about had them all the same year there for a while. Gloria thought. But the little sweethearts, Suzanne's 7, Amy's 2.5, Benji's 1.5 now. We do little things at home, special things, Daddy and the kids do. We real exciting things. We play tent. That's a real exciting game around home. Daddy and the kids get under the table, and we take one of the bed covers and put it over the chairs, you know, and play house, and the thing gets really exciting, you know, and kids are, they think that's great. And then one of the most exciting recent games we got, Benji's 1.5 years, and at first he was really Dad's kid, you know. And then he got kind of independent, and I couldn't get him to come to me. I'd say, you know, here, come on, Benji, and, you know, do the things that you're supposed to say to get a kid to come to you, and he wouldn't do it. And so finally, I run on a little routine where I said, hey, and you know, he'd just run on by me, you know, when I said the normal things. But I started saying, hey, Benji, would you like to see my fuzzy? And he'd be real cocky, but he'd turn around and look. I said, you want to see my fuzzy? And I, you know, I'd curl my arm like that and act like I was holding, however you would hold a fuzzy. And you know as much about holding fuzzies as I do, except. And so he'd come over, and when he'd get right at my lap to see my fuzzy, I'd grab him real fast and grab him and hug him, and he'd laugh, and Amy'd just get the biggest kick out of that. And Amy really thinks it's something now, because she's older and wiser than Benji. The fuzzy thing doesn't work on Amy, but she watches Benji, and every time I say, hey, Benji, you want to see my fuzzy? Amy waits, and then when it happens, she says, he did it again. That kid's never going to learn, you know. We do exciting things like that, and then in the middle of the night, Amy calls her pacifier, her poppity, and she'll say, Mommy, where's my poppity? In the middle of the night, 2 o'clock in the morning or 3 o'clock in the morning, you can't wake up the whole neighborhood looking for a poppity. But just last night, or the night before last, I went in there about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, and she was asking for a poppity, and I went in, and I was trying to find, have you ever tried to find a pacifier in a dark room on the floor in the middle of the night, you know, without, have you done that? And you can't wake up the rest of the kids or the Gloria and everybody else's family. So I hear a grown, dignified songwriter at 3 o'clock in the morning. He's on his hands and his knees, you know, feeling around trying to find the pacifier. And I finally find it, and I pick it up, and I give it to her. And then I quietly try to sneak out, and I stub my toe on her bed and wake up everybody. But last week we left, and I called back home, and Grandma said, we're only gone 2 or 3 nights. It's a very long, it's just 2 nights if we can help it. And Grandma said, you want to talk to Amy? And I said, yes. And Amy got on the phone. The first thing she said wasn't, hi, Daddy, or anything. She said, deep and wide, there's a fountain blowing deep and wide. Very little thing. Now, that might seem like a lot of just small talk to you, except it's exciting little things that we do around home when God has made possible. And Amy's going to Sunday school now and learning the Sunday school songs. And before we had kids of our own, sometimes we ignored them as far as our program is concerned. But I made up my mind here a while back we were going to include a song like this in all of our programs just for the youngins. And probably of all the songs we'll sing here this evening, this might be the most profound song that we'll use. Because some way in our involved, complex society, we've got so busy and so excited about making a living, and we forgot that the whole thing is that Jesus did die on the cross. And that he really does love us. Danny, sing it. Listen.
Jesus loves me. This I know.
For the Bible told me so.
For the Bible tells me so. And little ones to him belong. They are weak, oh, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me.
Sing it with us.
Yeah.